just pick up, please, a little bit?
Sure, she was asking if CSCR was going away.
Yeah, he did not hear your answer.
Yeah. And right now, I'm on one of the teams that's looking at that part of the problem. We can't find a solution to make CSCR stay, but we're looking for a solution that will do all what CSCR does.
I'd say as an activity, you know, I think this works, but you lose all of the really cool grading kinds of things, the assessment things that you can do in CSCR. There's no way to track a student's progress through this or time or anything like that.
So those are my two questions for you. Did you have to essentially had to recreate these?
Mm-hmm. And that's why I just made a new one.
Yeah, and two, you can't see the results of the student's progress.
I don't know of a way.
So one way to get some of that connected to the gradebook is to embed quizzes or to have links to quizzes throughout. And that's one of the activities that we have on the activity sheet. But let me, before we jump into that, how many of you have already been building cases in CSCR? Just a quick show of hands. All right. How many of you have ventured into Canvas to try to move your cases or rebuild cases in Canvas? Nobody. Okay. So this is interesting. How many of you have done the old PowerPoint link, hyperlink cases that are very linear and from PowerPoint to PowRPoint? Be proud. Raise your hands. Okay. Good. So this is looking familiar to you, right? In some ways. There are like, you click on the hyperlink and you go to the next slide, right? We suspect that a lot of cases can be done this way, but how do you track, and how do you give credit for getting right answers, and things like that are some of the questions that we're dealing with. Other questions, interactivity. Right now, Canvas is, they say that they're building a new quizzing tool that's gonna have all kinds of amazing stuff. Right now, you can put in H5P. How many of you have heard of H5P? All right, so a lot of you, and you've played around with it a little bit, you know that it can do some fun stuff. All of that can be embedded in Canvas. All of that can be embedded in quizzes in Canvas, in assignments in Canvas. So you can have interactions that end up with a question that you can design in your quiz question. And again, these are all things to start to play with here. I know that there are going to be some questions about, well, I want to do this, and I can't see a way to do this, and you're absolutely right. This is not the perfect replacement for case scenario critical reader, yet maybe ever. But it is what we have on campus, and it's what we're going to be working with. So hopefully, during the activity and after the activity, we can share some of the best ideas, because I know that you guys are all very smart. We'll be exploring some of these ideas. So I invite you now to take about 5-10 minutes and pick one of these things, get into Canvas, and try it out and see what it looks like. We have a case scenario on our homepage, if you go in there, that has taken it to the most ridiculous extent possible. If you look on the back page, you'll get hit, where we have H5P animations inside quizzes inside the case. So if you want to see how ridiculous that looks, I encourage you to go take a look at that. But otherwise, you can go experience the feel of what it looks like yourself. You may have to jump into the student view in order to actually. No, you don't actually. I don't think you do.
Yes, you won't work with us.
Okay. So go in, play around, and talk amongst yourselves. If you aren't doing it yourself, or you don't feel like it, look over your friend's shoulder and ask them questions as they're going through. And feel free to get loud. You can get coffee and get more cake.
Does anybody need enrolled in the Canvas course?
If you registered beforehand, you should have gotten an invitation. If you just walked in today.
If you just go to canvas.wisc.edu, yes. You should have a, did you register?
Yeah.
Okay, then you should have a
so
Canvas? Invitation.
It just won't work.
You're right.
once in the act,
and it also terrible. I can't get over it.
No, same. You can't get much in. You're in forever.
I think the last time I
was very hot. I don't know.
Oh, yeah, I have a green light.
I don't think it's all at all.
When's the next,
That and it should show up.
Or more.
Okay.
The week after showcase, I think showcase.
So these are some things that you can do. Here is, our activity sheet, this conversation today. I've got that mini case scenario that you can link out to, and then this basically is a step-by-step. I did.
We just have one, that we can review for a while.
See, and that's how I did it. I put, you selected whatever your option was, and it's like she said about the grid. So that's what my solution is.
Is it the same or is it?
And of course, this is the text in formal, our rich text formatting, right? So you could make this text as well that you just need to rep. So that way we can. So you can look at it, you have the power to be.
Diarrhea.
clean out all the facts or something like that.
Yeah.
You know, dash A.
Yeah.
It's a little clunky sometimes. It's really intuitive, but it's not going to be like, it's not going to be as polished as it can be. Which are painful. This is like, you know, people develop me. Yes, for us, it's like Wikipedia, there's going to be a little bit of edges you can do. Yeah, so. So, yeah, and that's a really, I really liked it. So, I think it.
For some of the things we're working on, press 1-4, it's like the one on the floor.
John, are we working
Alternatives here, what we do.
I like that.
not learning.
Figure out what.
Yeah, which is another option.
Anybody have any questions? Have you all had a chance to go to HVAC to play with us? They've got a list of all of the outlets.
So, the student does pick up heat, or she does.
Oh, it's current.
So the quiz was this.
I don't know if this is like. I'm not sure what.
You can't put it in a seat like there's a need to.
I'd like to invite you on the bottom of the activity sheet down here. Just go ahead and add in a wish list of things that you would like to see in a case scenario for the tool on campus, as well as, I don't know, any comments about it. What do you think? Yes. Amy, sorry. You're not wearing your hijack.
A lot of my instructors want to be able to retain what the students answer, even though they might not give credit or grading based on that. So they want to know, like, when they're having issues, when they're needing more clarification on topics, when they're incorrect answers, why they answer incorrectly. Also, some short answer, long answer situation too.
So, have you looked at the analytics in Canvas just to see who answered on what page for how long?
What was the comment?
The comment was, how do we track what student the pathways that students go through,
okay,
and how much time they spend on each page, and where are they getting stuck, and where are they taking wrong pages? Routes, is that right?
Yeah. Well, that's the main purpose of the case.
Just to see where the students, yeah, the main purpose is to see where the students are. Not quite getting it right, yeah. Good. Has anybody looked at the Canvas analytics to the extent where you can say, oh, I can totally do that there? So, okay, two questions. I know that Canvas analytics is one of the questions that we had a couple of weeks ago in one of the active teaching labs. Canvas analytics lets you look at one student at a time by default. There is now a There should now be an option in there that Dale put in that lets you give an aggregated, is that the right word? A view of all the students. It strips out the names and who does what or whatever, but sort of the class averages of that. I haven't looked at that yet, but he says that you put it in a week ago. Maybe it's in beta. Let's see. Because that was a problem that in order to see, is this page, is anybody looking at that? You'd have to go click on every student. And that was
cool. Just give me
a okay, right?
Broad information.
All right, so actually, yeah, I think that is, so you can see it by student here. Where did I get this?
It's not very specific.
Okay, it's not the same. So I actually don't know what I'm looking at here.
You have to have an activity. It has to be an associated activity or a
Yeah, it doesn't have a page
views
only.
I
It appears to be loading so slowly that I can't.
It just gives you frequency.
Okay.
It doesn't even break down which page.
My understanding is that there is going to be a button that gives you that by page view, I think. Okay. So that's on our list on the bottom of this. That's a wish list thing. Good. Anything else?
You can't show a window.
Yes.
I have a question. Is there any way to track the students' exercises, the points that they can earn, which was possible in critical reader case scenario? Is there any way to see how, well, first to assign points and then to get information how they did it?
I think currently the only way to do that is to link to quizzes from within the pages that you go to. So in any page that we have in our little case scenario here, we can have, oh, there it is, take the quizzing quiz. So you can ask a question, but maybe the only link is, you know, test your knowledge, and that goes to a mini quiz or however long you want that quiz to be.
In the list of quizzes that you have on the page, there is a quiz which has 22 points in the title. So I assume somebody has embedded some points in this quiz.
Oh, nice job, somebody. Yeah. Now, I don't think that there is a way to say, take these five quizzes that are in this single case and put them all together. I'm looking around to see if somebody says, oh no, that's totally easy. Go ahead. Tell me that it's easy. No, I don't think it's easy.
Can it be done?
I don't know.
Oh, okay. Being easy.
It's more of a grade book question of, you know, can you have like, subtotals of sections? All right, assignment groups. Yes, yeah. Can be.
But, can you put quizzes in assignment groups?
My case, yes. My case has okay. Five quizzes in it in that case, and that is the answer to the question. So, yes, this is why I love having smart people in here. All of you.
I think that points out another problem that we're talking about quizzes is that either you can hide quizzes or you can't. Like, I don't think you can hide specific quizzes because it'll be open to the students. If you have the quizzes tab available to the students, and they can go back in and change their answers to the case scenario questions afterwards. You see what I'm saying?
I think you can set permission so that once the quiz is taken, they can't take it again.
They would still be visible.
Could you conditionally release those?
Can you conditionally release them within a case? Like, you haven't seen it, you can't, it's not open until you open up this page? I don't know. All right, mastery paths, which is also under scrutiny right now. There are teams looking at that too, I'm sure. So this is good, we get all kinds of good questions.
Are there any language support tools inside of Canvas for non-English speaking? Text creation. So I work in French 100% of the time. Are there language support tools?
My understanding is that is built into Canvas, yes?
So it's as easy to type an accent using a PC as it is a Mac?
Experience, anyone? I don't work in that area. My suspicion would be we would not go to a tool that does not support foreign languages on this campus.
Because in Google Documents, you can't type an accent.
Okay.
You have to add an accent tab or tool. I'm just curious.
As a check-in, as a add-in sort of tool?
Yeah.
I don't have that problem on a Mac in Google. Mm-hmm. That's my first comment. My second comment is that I know like University of Chicago, University of Maryland, they've been using Canvas longer than us, and they have extensive use with the language department, so I would suspect that that's been addressed. I don't have that problem in Google either, though.
Oh, yeah.
curious
Are you using already a foreign language? You have your keyboard already mapped to the foreign language?
Mm-mm.
No.
I just use the key codes that I know, like the option E,
option
E kind of thing.
Sure.
Option U, U.
Yeah.
Yes, I've seen these in Canvas. Actually, yes, you can use this in Canvas as well. So if I add a page.
Now save it and see if it renders properly.
Oh, good question.
Yeah.
Yep. So good.
But only if you know the code, though?
Only if you know the code, but Google's got all the codes. So, easy thing to find.
Mac people know the codes. PC people are a little harder. It's like number and then
oh, yeah. Zero, one,
six, two.
What's that?
You just hold down the key.
Oh, yeah.
Just hold down.
Yeah,
but you have to have the numbers in your
right. That's my point. In order to be able to see the numbers, is there a window that comes
right.
up?
I see.
The person has nothing memorized. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
I don't think that's
your settings.
That's a personal
card. Settings is a language setting.
Perhaps.
Any other question?
Oh,
it's not
going to
happen.
There's like a number associated.
Yeah.
It's not really a question, but it's more of a comment, I guess, as to why
feels
it feels really easily.
Oh, it is.
Because, you know, it's one of those things where it would be great if you could nest
changes from time to time.
Right.
And then you have a new program, and it doesn't work.
Sort of
it doesn't work as an option.
You all to go to the Canvas community site and get that conversation going. We do have a UW-Madison group within the Canvas community site, but a lot of the questions, you can just do a search for, well, I don't know, hidden titles, hidden name pages, and I bet you anything that of the, I don't know how many thousands, hundreds, tens of thousands of Canvas users there are, but a lot of other instructors are dealing with the same questions, and many of them have workarounds for a lot of these things. Not all of them, of course. How many of you came today thinking that we would be able to leave with an answer to the beautiful case? Sorry! It's never easy. We were hoping to ask some good questions today and to show you some of the things that you can do. And I'm really a big fan of the H5P interactive stuff. And I think that there's going to be some fun stuff coming up from the new Canvas quizzing tool. I hope that they see the light about, as they're developing it, to say, hey, let's make it support cases. But again, if you get into this Canvas community, you can add your voice to that course.
I did have a question for the presenter. I was just wondering, what's the ease of use like in terms of like building this? How difficult it was to create in Canvas? Was it easier than CSCR? Was it more difficult? What were the things that were easier or more difficult? What did you find?
Yeah. Sure. I found the experience very similar to building a case in PowerPoint.
Okay.
Which honestly, I was more used to than the case scenario builder, so mm-hmm. It wasn't a huge transition for me. Like I said, the file structure was my biggest issue, but then again, it's the same problem with PowerPoint.
Sure. What was the most easiest part? What was the easiest part of building it?
The easiest part.
This was easy.
I think that the page itself is more versatile than a case scenario builder. You know, arranging the text. I think it looks prettier in Canvas than it did in Case Scenario Builder. I could use links, picture links,
sure,
instead of just boxes like you're forced into.
And if you want to make it look even prettier, check out the Canvas Style Guide. This is just HTML you can put in your page, and you can have things like accordions and tabs across the top, and other things like that. Also, check out, if you have not already, check out some choose your own adventure program writing tools. Keeping track of, like, all right, you're here, and now they get to go this way or that way. You can, like, fill up a huge whiteboard, a bunch of sheets of graph paper, or you can grab one of these tools. A lot of them are free, and they've already thought about some of the questions. They're like, all right, I come to a fork in the road. Do I take a left or a right? If I take a left, now I can do another fork. Keeping track of all of those forks, and then being able to get back to a common ending to sort of guide the students back to where you want them to go, is hard. So these tools help you do that. Also, when you're making case scenarios, think about how many branches you want to build, because it's a lot of work for you to build these branches, and the students aren't going to take them.
Right. Yeah.
So how? I mean, they'll take one, or they'll take maybe two, but how much effort do you want to put into them taking these multiple paths? It's a lot of cognitive load for you to keep track, also for them. So the more realistic, in some ways, the more realistic the case is, the harder it is, and again, they're not all going to take that path. But that's like any other questions, thoughts?
That's a question for the, so you said you've created these with pages, right?
Mm-hmm.
I wonder if you can get around the problem with the naming if you did this with HTML files and then added those as pages.
Can we hold pages, HTML files directly instead of pages?
You can certainly embed them.
Yeah, HTML pages, if you upload them, I believe they do render as pages.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
So you might be able to get around that that way. But if you did want to just stay with pages, you might consider, since the name is the name and that's what you get, and then that's the same thing as the tooltip hover over text or whatever, instead of saying, naming the page correct or something like that, calling it like, what did I say before, diarrhea scenario,
yeah.
Feedback A, feedback B, feedback C.
Naming convention is another thing.
Yeah, and don't have it where, you know, I guess think about it in your options. The list, the order of your options is your ABC or whatever code you use for that, so that A isn't always correct.
Right. Right. And I mean, if you were to use a naming convention, you also need to take into account the fact that Canvas wants to put it in alphabetical order. So if you want your case to be in chronological order, then you need to use like a numbering system up front.
And then we have one other question.
Yeah, I'm just wondering what Canvas is considering as options to CSCR.
I'm going to push that to somebody who's on the team, if they are willing to,
Mike,
even though they. I know that there are no decisions that have been made.
There's no decisions right now. Mm-hmm. Some of the tools we're looking at are Captivate,
Storyline,
Pressbooks,
Camtasia,
right.
Others.
Okay.
What we're trying to do is look at what's called a learning record store to push all the data there. And then that would also then talk that you could get all the data back out of there, and then that would push the grade back to Canvas.
Mm-hmm.
Also, Canvas with H5P, you might build that would also go to learning record store. So you could build some of the stuff even this way, and it would still work too.
Mm-hmm.
So we're trying to give you more options, but we just can't. We have to build our own learning record store just for testing.
Right.
And so we're working on that right now.
I just got an announcement today in my inbox this morning that H5P is now SCORM compatible with Moodle. Which is, sorry. but if it's SCORM compatible with Moodle, it might next week be SCORM compatible with Canvas, right? We don't know.
The other thing is people that do have CSCRs, we will not just say, if we can't get a solution by the end of when Canvas gets turned off, we will still keep some way for you to still use those, because I'm not going to let those people, unless there's like five people left or something like that, but we're getting a way to, that you're just not going to say, sorry, you don't have these anymore.
Right.
Well, there are whole departments who have.
Right.
You know.
No, but I mean, so just don't, even though it's going away, you might not have Moodle, but have a way to still run those CSCRs out of Canvas or something like that. We're looking at different options.
And,
so.
And I will say, when I did my internship project, we were running it mostly through D2L. The quizzes were in D2L, but they linked to Moodle. My students had no problem switching back and forth between platforms.
So schools still have a way for you to move across and give you time to move those across.
Thanks a lot.
So I'm trying now to also give you some hope, too.
I wish I could send you all away with a perfect solution, but I can't. I can send you away with cake and coffee. Please help me thank Jen for sharing her.